الرحيم نحمده ونصلي بسم الكريم أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. We open pray everybody is good and good spirits alhamdulillah and that everybody is uplifted by the period which we are in alhamdulillah through the barakah and grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala we have decided to put together a little of our own program and seeing that many people fasted today we didn't want to disturb you during the day rather that you have special times, special moments with your own family, reflections of Hajj. And then, inshallah ta'ala, you know, break iftar, which is a very Mubarak time, with your families. And then, you know, after Isha, because Maghrib and Isha is very early, so you have some time with your family, alhamdulillah, in a circle of dhikr, and continue in the same vein, in the piece of Hajj, remember, those that have been, that after the Arafah, then normally what happens is, you know, we move to Muzdalifah, and you know how difficult it becomes now. Now, the height of the Hajj, the height of your preparation, what you've learned all the number of years, come to fruition by the walk into the Jamarat and so on. Inshallah, for more than anything else, your dhikr is important for your strength tonight, alhamdulillah. So for those that are Hajj, Allah can Hajj, Makbulah, Mabrurah, inshallah ta'ala, and those that intend going, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant that they will soon be on the plains of Arafah, inshallah ta'ala. Our program is such that we will start with the dhikr, inshallah ta'ala, as we've done when we were together and all the other groups that have joined us also. We've always made the Ratib al-Haddad. And then inshallah ta'ala, a few words from both the A'imah and perhaps a few words of Shafiq's travel, inshallah. So the program works and runs, then inshallah, you know, Allah guides, protect us. It's also new to us. It's not in front of you. We're not physically in front of you, but inshallah, Allah guide us and grant acceptance of our efforts, inshallah. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Allahumma salli wa sallim ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala ali sayyidina Muhammad. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. اللهم صل وسلم على محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم حضرت النبي مصطفى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وصحبه ذريته وجميع أهل البيت الكرام الفاتحة فاتحة روح سماح الشيخين والسلام يا محمد الفاتحة وأهل الصالحين وإن الله في الله وارحمه في الجنة الله في الله وارحمه في الجنة اللهم كان محسنا من فازل الاحسان كان مصيعا في الدجال سيئة وحشرهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن اولئك رفيقا ذلك الفضل من الله كفى بالله عليما يا ايها الناس مطمئنه ترجعي الى ربك راضيه مرضيه فادخلي في عبادي وادخلي جنتي ان الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي والذين امنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى سيدنا محمد واصحابه وسلم سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين الحمد لله رب العالمين اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد الفاتح لما سبق والخاتم لما سبق ناصر الحق بالحق ولا دينا صراطك المستقيم وعلى آله وأصحابه حق قدره ومقدار العظيم وإلهكم إله واحد لا إله إلا هو الرحمن الرحيم الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم لا تحضر سنة ولا نوم له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه إلا بما شاء وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض ولا يؤوده حفظهما وهو العلي العظيم لله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وإن تبدوا ما في أنفسكم وتخفوا يحاسبكم به الله فيغفر لمن يشاء ويؤدب من يشاء والله على كل شيء قدير آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله قالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت هو على كل شيء قدير لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر سبحان الله وبحمده سبحان الله العظيم سبحان الله وبحمده سبحان الله العظيم ربنا اغفر لنا وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم ربنا اغفر لنا وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم اللهم صل على محمد اللهم صل عليه وسلم اللهم صل على محمد اللهم صل عليه وسلم أعوذ بكلمات الله التامة من شر ما خلق أعوذ بكلمات الله التامة من شر ما خلق بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم رادينا بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبمحمد الرسول النبي رادينا بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبمحمد الرسول النبي بسم الله والحمد لله والخير وشر بما شئت الله بسم الله الحمد لله والخير وشر بما شئت عبد الله آمنا بالله واليوم الآخر توبنا إلى الله باطنا وظاهرا آمنا واليوم الآخر توبنا إلى الله باطنا وظاهرا يا ربنا واعف عنا وامح الذي نامنا يا ربنا واعف عنا وامح الذي نامنا يا ذا الجلال والإكرام أمتنا على دين الإسلام يا ذا الجلال والإكرام أمتنا على دين الإسلام يا ذا الجلال والإكرام أمتنا على دين الإسلام يا قوينا يا أمتينا اكفي شر الله الليمين الله يا قوينا يا متينا اكفي أصلح الله قبور المسلمين، صرف الله شر المقيم، أصلح الله قبور المسلمين، صرف الله شر المقيم. يا هاليونا يا هكبيهن يا عليم يا الله خير يا الله سميع يا الله بصير يا لطيف يا حبيب الله يا علي يا كبير يا عليم يا الله قدير يا الله سميع الله بصير يا لطيف يا حبيب يا بارد الهم يا كاشف الغم يا هم العبد يغفر ويرحم يا فارج الهم يا كاشف الغم يا من لعبدي يغفر ويرحم استغفر الله رب المرايا ونستغفر الله من الخطايا نستغفر الله رب المرايا ونستغفر الله من الخطايا المعبود لا إله إلا الله 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 الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم شرف وكرم ومجد وأكرم رضي الله تعالى بصحابة أجمعين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل أعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب ومن شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل أعوذ برب الناس ملك الناس إله الناس من شر الوسواس الخناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس. الفاتحة. تبارك الله. هات الأرواح. حدد. اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار. يا أليم الصبر منا لا تهلك سترنا وعافنا وأغوانا وكلنا حيث كنا. يا الله لنا بسعادة والخاتمة بالشهادة. يا الله بدعوة مجابة والعرش مفتوح باب. يا الله لنا بالسلامة من هول يوم القيامة. يا الله بشربة هنيئة في يد خير البرية. يا الله بتوبة وقبول وإحسان. يا الله بتوبة قبل ترجع فان. يا الله بها. يا الله بها. يا الله بحسن الخاتمة. يا ربي جمع من طلبنا منك مغفرة وحسن الخاتمة. الفاتحة. يا لطيف يا لم يزل تبنا فيما نزل إنك لطيف لم يزل تبنا والمسلمين. يا لطيف ولم يزل تبنا نزل إنك لطيف ولم يزل تبنا والمسلمين يا مغيث أرنا واصرف عنا السوء يا مغيث أرنا واصرف عنا السوء يا مغيث أرنا واصرف عنا السوء. اللهم يا دائم الهدى يا صاحب المواهب وسلم على إن محمد الخير وراه السجية واغفر لنا بالعشية والصباحية للنبي لحن البيت القرام الفاتحة. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي والذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى سيدنا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون سلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. نحمده ونصلي رسول الكريم. أما بعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. We thank praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the best of praises, and we send salutations upon our Habib Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best of mankind, our ultimate role model and guide. We thank praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for having granted us to be alive, to be able to host this program, to be able to be around people with similar interests and people with similar mindsets, especially when it comes to those that have been on Hajj and those intending to go on Hajj, inshallah. Most definitely, we don't just have people online tonight that have been on Hajj, but also those that intend going, inshallah ta'ala. Mabruk, welcome to everybody, alhamdulillah. Our program is such that we started with the adhkar, dhikr, which is common amongst us on Thursday evening, dhikrat al-muhaddad, alhamdulillah, Allah accepted from us, inshallah ta'ala. And our adhkar and dhikrat al-muhaddad is made up of 90% of du'as and adhiyat that the Prophet made in different various periods of his life, alhamdulillah. And so it has been put together by his great grandchild, Imam Abdullah al-Haddad Ba'alawi, rahmatullahi alayhi, who put it together. And it's a very common dhikr that is made, alhamdulillah. When one is on travel, these type of things are things that, really bring people together. And we miss it, we long for it, we think a lot about it, alhamdulillah. And so when Thursday night does come along, especially in Aziziyah and on the days of Mina, then alhamdulillah, these things, really connect us as a group. So alhamdulillah, all praise and thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'll give my few words, inshallah wa ta'ala, and whatever we start, Sheikh Faik will be giving a few words as well, alhamdulillah. So inshallah wa ta'ala, we're trying to balance it out in this way. And as far as possible, we welcome everybody who have joined us, taking the time off, alhamdulillah, from your busy schedule. Everybody's busy at this period of time, busy with Eid preparations and so on, doing something, whatever the case may be, any soap flakes, any kabak de bruad, any pies, and amul de khut. One thing that is very significant, and I'm going to start off here with my few words, and that is that one poignant point always that hits home to me and drives home to me, on the night of Hajj, and especially after we've been Arafah, is and nothing compares to this. Wallahi bil-azim, this is my personal reflection, and I want to start off here, and that is that when you felt it, your jamarat, the first evening that you felt, when we felt the jamarat al-Aqaba, after we've been at Muzdalifah, the long walk in. Everybody knows the walk. One is quite tired, and one is going to felt the jamara. That evening, wallahi bil-adhim, I don't know, there's something specific about it, maybe it's because of the travels over the years and experience and perhaps things that you've heard of people of the past. But for me personally, when the labaik turns into the takbir, for Ketonians, I remember last year taking the microphone and thinking about this, and I'm reliving that tonight, going down the little bridge and takbir. I couldn't. I think it was somebody next to me who took the mic from me. It always breaks me at that moment. It always breaks me. A reason being that one grows up, you know, in masajid, if one used to take the mic to perform takbir in the masjid, one knows that the Ketonian style of performing the takbir is very special. And that you've come through a great difficulty, alhamdulillah. And now you have to put your money where your mouth is. It's all okay in Mina. You sit, you're quiet, you're doing your ibadat and so forth, tasbih salah. And then the next day is Arafah, you're still sitting, and you're making dua. But to sit and make dua and just to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness, that's one side of it. Dhikr goes with fikr. Dhikr goes with understanding, right? And when there's movement, haraka, there's baraka. When there's movement, there's blessings. So even the one of the great said of the Ba'alawi said that in the time of Nabi Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, he had to touch the water with his stick. Then only the water opened up. Which in the Maryam said next to the tree, she had to shake the tree for the dates to fall. It wasn't just always given to us. And so for those that have come on Hajj and those that did going, you know the money you spend, the time, the effort, it's not easy. We have to go through a process of learning. We have to make mistakes. Ramadan is the same. Ramadan is not only for the pious, for those who make i'tikaf. Ramadan is for those that are naughty boys or naughty girls, or those that don't do what is good, those who don't salah on time, those who do sins and have shortcomings. All of us, may Allah forgive us all. And so also is Hajj, that they didn't ask for specific people to come. Right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala invites, alhamdulillah. And so when you walk up towards the, however tired you might be, from that night, through Muzdalifah, through the tiredness of shaving of legs and so, and you go and felt, suddenly there's a resurgence of energy. What is this? What is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala trying to tell us? Oh, ya am Allah, ya am Allah, labbaik, Allahumma labbaik. But it turns into takbir. Really, you are great. I can't explain it into words. I can't put it into words. I can't. I'm weak. I'm going to make a dua. Then is it what the Prophet said? Is it what the tabi'i? Am I going to say something that the Sheikh said? I don't know what to say to Allah. So what I say, Allahu Akbar. You are great. You have nothing more to say. That Akbar, that takbir says it all. So once emotions take over, and the famous hadith of Rasul says, "Man arafa nafsahu faqad arafa rabbahu." He who knows himself, he knows Allah. He gets to know himself. So when we sit on Arafah, we made dua and we spoke about our sins. We knew what we did. Only us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But just think for one moment that while we were doing those sins, Allah did not punish us at that moment. So Allah gave us a respite. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala waits a period of time before punishment happens, even for things that we do. Here we have the opportunity to have performed the Hajj and Arafah and ask ma'af. But it's much more than just words. So from there, we felt the tamarat, I want it out of me. And then from there, we go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, making the tawaf al baytullah, walking the sigh, showing that our life is between hope and fear, a balance, the scale on the good and the bad, the scale of the qiyamah, the sunnah of Sidna Hajar, the sunnah of our mother, the sunnah of how she gave birth, the pangs. We walk a sunnah of a lady. Men feel it. The sigh, men feel it, subhanAllah. And then we, you know, clip our hair if we haven't done it before. And we are free like newborn babies. SubhanAllah. This whole journey is miraculous. There's something exceptional about it, alhamdulillah. There's so much lessons to be learned. Alhamdulillah, we have the opportunity to sit outside of the haram at night to not only speak about Makkah and so, but to do the cures of the heart, to look at our spiritual diseases. In that way, the idea was that inshallah ta'ala, that beyond the Hajj, some of us don't change in 5 days. But what if, since last year, what has changed? Have we grown closer? Have we forged relationships with each other? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forced us into isolation to start loving one another, to talk to our children, to talk, to sit as a family, to work together, to see the concerns of others, to see family members pass away, and you cannot be there for them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches, you can't just say, Barakah Rajab, Barakah Sha'ban, Balighna Ramadan. You're going to see Ramadan, you're going to see Sha'ban, you're going to seek my forgiveness in Rajab. Alhamdulillah, everybody might not be able to go. Just think of it, the 2019 Hajj, those that are online. So just think about the 2019. You actually get to be Hajjis for 2 years. 2 years in a way, Alhamdulillah. So Arafah brings back good memories, especially last year from the rain and so. Every year was special, Alhamdulillah. For all those that have joined us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you khairat and barakat and afia and goodness, inshallah ta'ala. And may your Hajj be accepted, inshallah ta'ala. You had the opportunity to see Qiyamah before Qiyamah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it, inshallah ta'ala. And may we continuously labbaik for life. And if ever we are needed by our masajids, by our madrasas, by, you know, some good thing that our civil society needs, you raise up your hand and you say, Ya am, labbaik, Ya am. Allah, I'll serve. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us understanding, inshallah. This is my few words. I hand over to beloved Sheikh Faik, who's online. I can see him there. So it's in Sheikh's Angetrek and so. We ask him to say a few words, inshallah ta'ala. And then we'll make dua to us. And we'll ask, you know, if Rita's on to say a few words also, inshallah ta'ala. Fadda mashkura. Bismillah, Sheikh.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh, Imam, and everybody that's listening. A'udhu min ash-shaytan ar-rajim, bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul 'uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. Allahumma la 'ilma lana illa ma 'allamtana innaka antal 'alimul hakim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar, Allahu akbar. لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر ولله الحمد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وأزم في الناس بالحج يأتوك رجالا وعلى كل ضامر يأتين من كل فج عميق ليشهدوا منافع لهم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Holy Quran, we clearly state unto us that the call of Hajj has come and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has asked and commanded Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam to make that call. And alhamdulillah for those who have been heed that call. And for those who made niyyah to go, inshallah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring that call close for them, inshallah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them the opportunity in order to perform that call and to stand close to Dabar Rahmah and also to be close to the Kaaba and to gain the benefits and all the barakah of these places that they will be visiting, inshallah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makbul all the hajj, all the ibadah of the hujjaj. Those who are there, and like we have also mentioned previously, that you know that these people that are on Arafah, they always make dua for the ummah as well. So when the dua is made for the ummah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept that dua from them, inshallah, for all of us. Yes, your Imam has spoken now, and alhamdulillah, he's touched on various aspects, you know, and it was comprehensive. Reminded me also of the khutbah of the Imam this afternoon, when the Imam has also made a very comprehensive khutbah, speaking about general life all over the show and so on, everything, the difficulty that people are in with the pandemic and all of these. And yes, and everybody speaks about the Hajj and the beautiful experiences that people have had and having over the Hajj period. And it is a time that there's no comparison. There is nothing that is the likeness of Hajj. You can go for Umrah many, many times and over. And also a person can go for Hajj, right? There is a great difference between the two, as we know, as the Ibadah is concerned. But even the experience, and it's also even the feeling and the intention and the specifically the sincerity, devotion and dedication that goes into Hajj. Let alone the severity and, you know, and there are difficulties as well when it comes to Hajj. It's not just an easy trip, but it's a journey of a lifetime. And it's a journey that one wants to feel and do for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like Imam has mentioned also about Nabi Musa and Sidna Maryam. You know, it didn't just come by itself and it wasn't given to them on a silver platter. Even our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had to struggle and work hard in order to give this message over to those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and those who want to accept the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Hajj in itself was a call that has been given by Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Historically, we have read and we have heard and we have spoken about the advent of Sayyidina Ibrahim and how he specifically made the call, you know, when he said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but you know, he's going to listen to me. There's nobody that's listening to me. And Allah has commanded him to do the command and to call, and people will listen. And even up till today, thousands of years today, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted people to listen to that very same call of Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. And not even stopping then, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has confirmed with him in order to give him satisfaction and also to bring him to peace. And that is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ya'tuka rijal, and people will come walking. You know, this is how eager people will be in order to specifically to come and perform this ibadah. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, ya'tuka rijal, wa ala kulli damir ya'tina min kulli fajjin amir. You know, they will come on a camel, they will come on a horse, they will come at all particular corners of the, all four corners of the earth, they will be coming and they will be traveling by whatever and however means. And today we find the world has become very small and people are in a jiffy and people are just particularly from whatever place they live and they travel from very quickly on a plane. And there we go. Nowadays, the trains are also working. And this is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لِيَشْهَدُوا مَنَافِعَلُمْ. And this is just basically to witness the benefits of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you know, one can elaborate on this and one can actually speak on many things pertaining to the benefits of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We know there's ayat that has been read to us many a times where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned that, you know, the benefits and the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala it's innumerable. You know, people cannot, you won't be able to count all the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this way Allah wants us to come there to Mecca, to come and see the benefits of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I mean, what is there for us to see? What is really to see? There's the Holy Kaaba, is there with the grave of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Haram of Mecca, the Haram of Medina, and then there is Arafah, Muzdalifah, Mina, its places. But there's nothing that specifically that you're going to come back home with. Arafah is just an open land. Muzdalifah is a vacant space. Mina, there's the bridge of the Jamarat where you take your stones and you're going to pelt it. All of these are there. Those are signs that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has particularly mentioned also in the Holy Quran. The ayat, the signs, you know, and those particular things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has demarcated in order for us to get to and to look at and to make the ibadah that is being performed by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so that we can gain the benefit of this particular ibadah. Hajj is something is deeper than that. Hajj is much deeper than that, brothers and sisters in Islam. You know, Hajj, it's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has mentioned, Al-Hajjul Mabrur laysa lahu jazaun illa al-Jannah. There's nothing, no other reward that a person can gain for performing Hajj, but that is Jannah. So then, other than the rituals, then walking around the Kaaba for Tawaf, between Safa and Marwa for the Sa'i, to go to Arafah and spend the day there on Arafah performing your two salawat, which is the Dhuhr and Asr in Jam' al-Qasr that you're particularly going to perform there. And from there, moving to Muzdalifah, picking up the pebbles to fell the Jamarat, the first night, which is the night of tonight, that we, the Hujjaj, will perform the pelting of Jamaratul Aqaba. And that is the beauty of it, with the change of the Talbiyah, where we have called upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala today by saying, Labbaik Allahumma Labbaik, O Allah, here am I. And we have pleaded to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all aspects of life. And like we've mentioned previously also, that the Arafah is not just about tawbah, not just about making tawbah and asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness, but to make direct contact with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why Allah brings us from far and wide, and all the different over the oceans, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings us to that particular little place where there's a small little mountain. Today there's a little column that stands on top of it. And Allah brings us there in order to recognize none other but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah brings us there not to, to come and see what a rock looks like, not to come and see where the Prophet stood in order to make the khutbah, in telling people that, you know, I will not be able to see you here next time. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you know, and he says, and he placed on in front of us our whole life, how we need to live, how we need to experience life, how we need to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how we need to serve humanity, deal with everything in this life in the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to deal with, and also to be subservient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and specifically to mankind. You know, to be a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and dedicated servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and showing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gratitude by sharing, by giving. Like Imam has mentioned also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forced us into a situation in order to bring out that qualities that we have that is dormant within us, that beautiful kindness, that love, that caringness of ourselves, and all of these type of qualities that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala specifically exposed from us when we go on Hajj. And yeah, Allah has done it with this pandemic. We have to look at our wives seven days a week, you know, 24 hours a day, our children. We have to deal with them. We have to speak to them in kind ways. We have to do things in the best of our ability and make do with what we have. This is the beauty. Nothing in excess. Allah shows us that, showed us that we are an ummah and wasata. We are an ummah that is a medium ummah. No, in Afrikaans, I say, it was a middle-matige ummah. Which is, we are an ummah that specifically show the middle way. And what do we do? We're not in excess of anything. We don't exceed limits. And this is what the Hajj teaches us. Share and love and care, you know, and concern. And specifically think of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has honored us with. And here we find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لِيَشْهَدُوا مَنَافِعَ لَهُمْ. Come and see the benefits what I have given to everybody. Even those in former years, they came to see the beauty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's greatness. And you know what that is? It is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he specifically said, قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. He was asked a question. The Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم was asked a question. He said, أَيُّ الْأَعْمَالِ أَفْضَلْ. The person asked the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم, Ya Rasulullah, what is the best and the most beneficial deed that I can perform? The Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم said, قَالَ إِمَانُ بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِ. Very firstly, Allah, the Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, have iman in Allah and believe in his Rasul. This is what Hajj is, brothers and sisters. And after that only, the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, ثُمَّ مَاذَا, and what is after that, Ya Rasulullah? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, قَالَ الْحَجُّ الْمَبْرُورِ. A Hajj that is an obedient Hajj. But firstly, he said, إِيمَانُ بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِ. Believe in Allah and his Rasul. Dedicate our lives and this pandemic and what we have been going through for the past couple of months has taught us to know other dependents, those who want to believe and those who don't want to believe in Allah. And those who believe in Allah, we have been taught specifically how to be completely devotedly dependent on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and none other. Allah has taken lives, young, old, healthy, sick. And sometimes the sick people have particularly survived better than those who are young, and it is mentioned and said to us that, you know, the elderly, they are high-risk people. But Allah grant him maybe to go through this even better than what the younger people, and mostly people that have died that I know of, that was young people. But yeah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches us complete and full dependence on none other but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, qala imanu billah. The best deed that you can have, you can do, is iman in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you are in difficulty, believe in Allah. Depend, have sabr. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Holy Quran, if you have difficulty, then you believe in Allah, you have sabr, and you make salah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will particularly serve you. You show sabr. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, those who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and show sabr, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will deal with them in the apt and the appropriate manner. And here we can see that Hajj today is in, has been done in, I've never seen it. Wallahi, for all the years that I've been traveling, I don't know how Sheikh Ridha is feeling, but you know, I have been completely overtaken by emotions most of the day. For the simple reason why, this is the time that we serve the Duyuf al-Rahman, that we serve those who are the guests of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What a humble job to do, if I can call it a job. I need to serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a way to look after his guest, to see to their comfort. And yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala deals with us in the best manner. You know, he gives us everything in order to serve others. Those who are on Hajj are the kings and the queens. They will be in the domain of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when they're on Arafah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not reject anything from them on that particular, on the day of Arafah like today. Can we imagine, and according to my hearing, it was about 10,000 people that has been on Hajj today. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted one of those hujjaj's dua for the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then we are saved. Only one. And 10,000 is a drop in the ocean of people that particularly go under normal circumstances. And what the protocol that has been followed today, if we look at it, it's impossible to do any other time. It is impossible to follow that protocol. And in that way, beautifully, it's been laid out. But that is only for that amount. And now the time will come that people have to decide on what to do for the future. The dependence on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have to be completely. Some of us are older. Some of us have great desires to go. And don't despair. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant us that opportunity to go and stand in front of the Holy Baytullah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Go and stand on Jabal Rahmah, specifically on Arafah, on the day of Arafah. That is what Allah will grant us, inshallah, bi-idhnillah. As long as we believe and serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should be served. Teach our children the very foremost tenet of Islam, and that is, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. There is none other to worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to testify and to witness like nothing else but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is your creator. Although Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it clear that those who believe, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam makes it clear also, those who say, man qala la ilaha illallah dakhala al-jannah, those who even just say la ilaha illallah, and he depend on that saying, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant him Jannah. We say, wal hajjul mabrur, laysa lahu jazaun illa al-jannah. That a hajj that is mabrur, a hajj that is particularly accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, an obedient hajj, not only accepted, not maqbool only, but that is mabrur, an obedient hajj. For those who have been last year, that have been with us on hajj, I think if you sit still and think from then to now, all the trials that you have been going through, the tests that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed in front of you, how to sidestep them, how to avoid them, it wasn't easy. It was a difficult task. Until today, you can reflect upon your day that you stood in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on Jabal al-Rahman. And you can reflect upon the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and be grateful for that. And even if you have erred, we can still say, Ya Rahman, forgive us. Tawbah Ya Rabbi, Tawbah Ya Allah, Tawbah Nastaghfirullah al-Azim. Tubtu ilayka Ya Rabbi, we're making Tawbah to you, O Allah. We're asking you for your forgiveness. We're asking you, O Allah, to redesign our lives. Grant us to structure our lives in such a way that will be beneficial for us, for ourselves in the dunya as well as in the akhirah. Grant us the benefit of our hajj that we have performed. Ons is maar net 'n jaar oud. Ons is jong kindertjies nog wat concern ons hajj. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us to be of those that will gain the definite blessings of this particular day of Arafah. Like Imam has mentioned, man arafa nafsa, faqad arafa rabba. The one who knows himself, the one who come to realize after hajj, I have been a certain individual. I need to make changes. And he start to do that. فَقَدْ عَرَفَ رَبَّهُ. He will start to realize who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. He will start to realize the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will start to realize the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The maghfirah, the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And brothers and sisters in Islam, the way that we have to do this is to learn and to make sure that we inform ourselves with the depth of this beautiful deen of Al-Islam. Make sure that we make an effort in order not to just listen to things, but to go and learn and proper learning the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are many scholars, there are many imams, there are many shuyukh that particularly will teach us this beautiful deen. Let us do that and show our eagerness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're making dua and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to remove this pandemic. These are things that will not just be relieved. We will not just be relieved from easily. This afternoon, the Imam on Masjid al-Namra, he mentioned that this difficulty of the pandemic that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed in front of us, it is not to bring us down, but it is to bring us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I sat and I listened to this man and I thought to myself, Ya Allah, how apt it is to listen on the day of Arafah, to say to people that this difficulty that we are in, it is only but a call that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sending to us to come closer to Him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us iman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our sins, our families, our brothers, our sisters, our children, and those who are our parents, for those who have passed on, and those who are specifically alive still, forgive ourselves, all of us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be merciful upon us. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the opportunity in order to be of those that will make an effort in order to remove obstacles in our ways. And the obstacles is that blank that we have in front of us. When we want to do something, then we're not sure of what we are doing. But that we do something with complete conviction for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that we live with love and care and kindness and humility. You know, that we can, Afrikaans het mooie woorde ook, om beliefdig te wees met mens en om mooi te wees met een en die ander. And this is what we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I would ask Imam also, for those who have passed on, to make dua for those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala must grant them nur in the qabr, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala must forgive them their sins, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala must grant them the high place in Jannah, inshaAllah. For those who are sick, grant them, Ya Rabb, grant them their health back, and also grant them to have sabr within their illnesses and to go through the challenges. And there's also hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that if you cannot find a remedy for your illness, the best thing to do is to have patience, to have sabr. For the sabr alone is a form of healing. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant those who are in that particular difficulty to have lots of sabr. And for us, that are trying to live our Hajj, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy upon us. That we can be an inspiration for others, so that others also want to be eager and to rush over to go and perform the Hajj. Like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, when he stood particularly in Medina in front of the people, he said, Ya ayyuhan nas, qad farada alaykum al-hajj fahujju. O mankind, that Hajj has become a fard and been hasted in order to perform it. Right? So, and here, the beauty of it is Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Ya ayyuhan nas, which means it was at a time even when there was non-Muslims also specifically in the nearby vicinity. And when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that, it meant that Hajj became a fard. So you that is not yet in the domain of Islam and not yet a Muslim, that will become a fard on you as soon as you have accepted the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this also shows that we should show humanity. Also what the Sheikh has mentioned this afternoon. We have to be human beings, live like proper human beings, not seeing down upon anybody else. Sadaqah, we can give to anybody. Zakah, we know we are only restricted to give to certain people. But when it comes to sadaqah, you know, give to others. Don't be of those that once we get to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of Qiyamah, we want to come back in order just to give a small sadaqah. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to us, do it now, even as small as a date, that can be a sadaqah. A kind word can be a sadaqah. This is all what Hajj teaches us, brothers and sisters. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the willingness in order to seek the necessary knowledge of Islam. And may He grant us once again the opportunity. I myself is really longing to be back in Makkah. Really longing to see the Holy Kaaba, longing to walk on the grounds, on the beautiful grounds of Medina, standing in front of our beautiful Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, reading salawat on a different level, you know, and just having that aura, that feeling, that smell, you know, and that the temperature of Medina and Makkah's heat, just feeling that it's just a beautiful, you know, feeling. Just one can close your eyes and you can think about these places, and wallahi, and Allah can bring it right to me in front of you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the opportunity again in order to return back to Makkah, inshaAllah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the opportunity to maybe stand once again on the holy places of Arafah. The people will be moving to Muzdalifah, as you know. Some of them will be leaving after the second half of the night and move on to Mina, to Pel Jamaratul Aqaba. Some is going to do the first tahallul, so let's say reclaim full ocean. Some will be returning back to Mina, and some will be going to Makkah to perform the Tawaful Ifada and the Sa'i. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy on them, inshaAllah. It's a beautiful, I think if we have to talk about our experience of last year, and the rain that we had, how beautifully did Allah speak to us with that rain, and how beautifully did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the opportunity even to go back to Makkah. And yet when we got to Makkah, the rain has subsided, and you know, things were completely different. So yes, may Allah make it, and I believe that rain last night as well for those people on Hajj, may Allah make it easy on all of them. And I think, you know, if we have to return back to Makkah, I think we will particularly doing things even more and better than what we have done. I think the best that we have done was our first Hajj. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant all of us Hajj Maqbool and Hajj Mabroor. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the benefit of this Hajj in the dunya as well as in the akhirah, inshaAllah. I want to say shukran to everybody for allowing myself also the opportunity to speak to you once again, and also to Sheikh Rida, you know, to grant him, Allah must grant him all the health and strength, and his family, his mother, and his wife, and his children, and his family, Sadiq, and his sister, and all of them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant all of them all the khair and barakah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open the doors that we as Shafiq traveling towards will be back on the road, inshaAllah, in order to serve none but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them, you know, to the opportunity in order to once again serve the Hujjaj, which is Duyuf al-Rahman, the guest of the Most Merciful. Imam, I want to say to you also, shukran, and kullu amu antu bi khair to everybody. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you all, everybody, a blessed Eid, inshaAllah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the barakah of the Eid and those who are going to slaughter. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you the benefit of the slaughtering, inshaAllah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant that particular slaughtering to relieve all the difficulties from all of us, inshaAllah. Shukran, Imam, and shukran to everybody. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward us all, inshaAllah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Shukran, Imam.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. I don't think Sheikh has to run away. Sheikh did my job actually now with the thanking. And, you know, has to come to this, Sheikh Rida has a bit of a problem with his Wi-Fi at the moment. And so, and I think it's more also that he doesn't want to say a few words. He's always in the background, hiding. And so, we're trying to speak to you the whole time, trying
as to get usual.
You to be with us, alhamdulillah. Whatever the case may be, we are trying to the best of our ability, inshallah ta'ala, to get him online. But whatever the case is, I have been asked a task of the following. Firstly, all praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and granted us to be able to contact one another, albeit via the airwaves, you know, and not physically perhaps, but alhamdulillah, at least we could be able to put this program together. The Hajis probably since the time that we've left of 2019 has been nagging for us to do something. A reunion was planned, a very, very good one, alhamdulillah. And then also this program, as many other groups also will be coming together and doing something, or they've probably done something today, alhamdulillah. So praise belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, regardless of the health and strength to, you know, be able to see one another again. We are saddened by many things, firstly about, you know, being in contact with one another and so, but also that we have lost two of our Hujjaj during this period of time, 2019. Significantly, strangely, and coincidentally, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that both of them sat in wheelchairs. Hajj Hadija, who we called our beloved mother on the strip, alhamdulillah, became extremely close to myself, in Aziziya, alhamdulillah. And also our brother, I had the opportunity to, you know, go and teach him on a Saturday afternoon with his sister, Abrar Karole, who lost his leg. And both of them were, you know, amputees on a Saturday afternoon because he couldn't come out to a class. And both of them, as Allah willed, was taken away. And if one just reflects a little bit about their journey, the fact that they were in a wheelchair, the two of them were people that never, ever complained about anything. Nothing was a burden to for them or to them. And they were shining examples of us who are healthy, fit and strong, alhamdulillah, who are able to move our limbs. And really, words fail us when it comes to the two of them. It is so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted them to come to Him, and our du'as is such that they be granted Jannah, inshallah ta'ala. So all those that have lived or lost loved ones during this period of time and before, and those that we know of, those we don't know of, our asati dadina, you know, people that we know, people that have taught us, alif ba'ta, may Allah grant them Jannah, and our beloved parents. Alhamdulillah. Sheikh always on his trips mentions the story of 1979 of his beloved mother, mentioning that she hopes and she prays that in every household there is a hafiz al-Quran, a hufad, somebody who has memorized the Quran. And today it is a possibility, it is true, it's real, lots of children are learning. And that struck me significant. It's something that is true and real. On this specific journey, also where the Hadija, unfortunately, also slipped from the bus, was a very poignant point of the journey. There were very humorous moments. There were moments of sadness. Same with 2017, the night when the boosters and the lights went out on Arafah, and we left extremely late. we had very short time. Last year, we had a lot of time at Muzdalifah again. It happens like that. And nothing is planned. And don't go with perceptions. Be like a puppet in the hands of the puppeteer. And Allah will take you. Alhamdulillah. So from Ridha's side, he's mentioned that he must thank everybody who has put their trust in them to be able to take them on this journey of a lifetime. Alhamdulillah. You know, and then also to those that have put their trust in him to take them, but unfortunately have not been able to go, to not lose hope and not to have despair, that inshallah ta'ala, you know, that they will look them up again. As you know, money has had to be given back and all these things, and so, and no agent could take things from people. So hopefully people will be able to put their trust again in them next year, inshallah ta'ala, to be able to facilitate the journey, inshallah ta'ala. From his mother as well, you know, his beloved mother, who's the backbone really of the organization, if you want to call it. His beloved father passed away, may Allah grant him Jannah, inshallah ta'ala. And he's always scared to upset the memory of his father. And that's a good thing. I have the same. Allah keep us like that, inshallah. And then also to his brother-in-law Sadiq, the loud mouth Sadiq, who keeps things active and alive and so forth. Very busy during the Umrahs for Ramadan. They have immense strength and power and ronatup and ayatangadun, alhamdulillah. Allah keep them in that way, alhamdulillah, and his da'wah work that he's doing in the townships. And then also his family behind the scenes, sisters and so. I mean, you, the legend, Allah keep him strong, inshallah ta'ala. May he continuously be with us, and his strength, as we know, lies in his moustache. And so, like Nabi Daniel, and so maybe in his strength in the hair, his strength lies in his moustache, alhamdulillah. So may Allah keep him strong, healthy, many more years with us, inshallah. And then Sumaya Ori, that's the first person you see when you come to Shafiq's travel. Allah bless her, guide her, protect her. She recently lost a brother about a month ago, my neighbor, Walid Ori. Their father was Ismail Ori. Years in the Hajj industry. Allah grant him Jannah, inshallah ta'ala. We lost him to COVID. Allah grant him Jannah, inshallah ta'ala. And then those on the airport staff, Rahman, and all the others who assist on the day when people leave. There are many people behind the scenes who do exceptional work, and words fail us when it comes to them. But thanking them, Allah bless you, inshallah ta'ala. Guide, protect your families, inshallah ta'ala, min al-ameen. Then from outside, in terms of planning this program, Brother Samir Franciscus, he's not sitting in George. Listen to my words, he's sitting in Georgia. Georgia is up north in Turkey, close to Russia. He went for work and lockdown happened and he's still there. His father suffered a big stroke. And, you know, he's involved with Azawiya Masjid in terms of their websites and so. And Sheikh Siraj passed away. And so he wasn't here for those occasions. We thank him and we're really appreciative of the fact that he has to stay up a bit later for us here in Cape Town. He's a man that enjoys this, loves the Ratul Haddad and so. So we thank him, Shukran Samir Franciscus. And then his cousin, his host here, Fadl Sali, who is doing everything from the side. Well done to you guys. I mean, alhamdulillah, we just checked now. We have over, Sheikh, we have almost 300 viewers.
Allah
300 Allah. Viewers on tonight. That is extremely good on YouTube Live. It will be recorded and you can watch it again at another time on YouTube, inshallah ta'ala. So we will take a summary of what we've done tonight. Inshallah, may it be a benefit to people who attend classes. There are new things in the pipeline beyond this. You know, Sheikh and myself, we're looking at some things, inshallah ta'ala. And exciting things that we want Shafiq's travel to have personally for its travelers, inshallah. So make dua that things go well, that things are successful, and that we are able to, you know, not just Ahmiya, but that we are actually able to put it into practice, inshallah ta'ala. So, Sheikh, from your side, perhaps anything that you want to add? And so, in terms of thanks?
No, yes, Imam, just like we have said, we're thanking Sheikh Ridha and family, for Shafiq travel and tours, but also the Ajiz, Sheikh, that has been traveling with us, those who traveled last year and previous years, It's always nice to have traveled with our people. Lots of challenges, but alhamdulillah, there's always strength after the challenges. And alhamdulillah, I must say shukran to all of those who always assist us so well, you know, and those people who overlook our shortcomings, and also ask them to, you know, to make dua for us and forgive us if we have erred in any way where they were concerned. Doesn't matter which year they traveled with us. But also zukmas manit means, and sometimes we also falter and make mistakes. So yes, I say shukran to all of those people that we have traveled with previously. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bond ourselves through the Hajj, and like you have said, you know, so that we can do better things for the future, and for none other but for the Yuf Rahman, for those people who will be traveling, you know, to serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And yes, and our parents, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them my place in Jannah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive them all their mistakes and so on. And whatever we do, may it be a screen for them from the fire of Jahannam, inshallah. Like you have mentioned, you know, my beloved mother that has always made that dua. And I think I will echo that dua also in the same time, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala must still grant many, many houses to have Hufaz in their homes. And not only Hufaz, but people that understand and live the Quran and love the Quran and love the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I say shukran to all of those who have learned and sit in our classes. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward them greatly, inshallah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, forgive all our shortcomings. I say shukran to you also, Imam. I must say it's very wonderful to travel with you, very humoristic, and also learned a lot from you as, you know, on the travel. And alhamdulillah, may Allah keep you in the way that you are. And may your family also just honor you and respect you and be diligent with you in the time that you are not home. I know that the wives, both our wives, they must serve one another. My beloved wife, she's also sitting here next to me. Imam, I have to say it on YouTube and on, you know, on air that I must say she's sacrificing a mighty lot for me and for us and my household. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant everything of the best in dunya and in akhirah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, grant her all her wishes. And ek dink sy het nog een groot verlange. Ek sal vra vir die umma om amin te sê op dit. En dat sy sal lyk om weer te staan op Arafah in order to make a hajj again. Allah grant her that wish, inshallah. Amen. Shukran to each and everyone. I think for me it was a wonderful evening. Also to speak to others, inshallah. May we have a chance to speak to one another again, inshallah.
Amen. Inshallah. With this, we package with the dua, inshallah, Allah accept the promise. And those that are suffering, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ease the suffering. Palestine, Kashmir, and all those places. As a possible, Allah grant Jannah. Those that are sick and ill, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them health, and may the sickness be a form of tawbah, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfill our halal desires, inshallah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a good ending the day that we pass away, inshallah. Ta'ala. We'll ask the Sheikh to lead us in dua, inshallah. Fatiha.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala ishrafil mursaleen. Sayyidina wa nabiyyina maulana Muhammad. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka antas samiul alim. Wa tub alayna wa ighfir lana innaka antat tawwabur rahim. Rabbi ij'al lana muqima salatana wa min dhurriyyatina. Rabbana wa taqabbal du'a. Rabbana ighfir lana wa liwalidayya wa lilmu'minina yawma yaqumul hisab. Allahumma ahina bil iman wa amitna bil iman wa ahsinna bil iman wa adkhilna al jannata bil iman bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. Allahumma inna nas'aluka imanan kamilan wa yaqinan sadiqan wa rizqan wasi'a wa qalban khashi'a wa lisanan dhakira wa halalan tayyiba wa tawbatan nasuha wa tawbatan ya Allah qabla al maut wa rahatan 'inda al maut wa maghfiratan wa rahmatan ba'da al maut wal 'afwa inda al hisab wal fawza bil jannati wan najata min al nar. Allahumma ihdina fi man hadayt wa 'afina fi man 'afayt wa tawallana fi man tawallayt wa barik lana fi ma a'tayt wa qina bi rahmatika wa asrif 'anna sharra ma qadayt fa innaka taqdi wa la yuqda 'alayk innahu la yadhillu man walayt wa la ya'izzu man 'adayt. تبارك ربنا وتعاليت، لك الحمد على ما قضيت ولك الشكر على ما أعطيت، ونستغفرك اللهم من جميع الذنوب والخطايا ونتوب إليك. اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا وعافنا واعف عنا وقنا من كل بلاء الدنيا وعذاب الآخرة، وارزقنا يا الله رزقا واسعا حلالا طيبا وعملا صالحا بلو سلامة في الدين والدنيا والآخرة. توفنا مسلمين وألحقنا بالصالحين غير خزايا ولا مفتونين يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعلهم حجهم حجا مبرورا، وسعيهم سعيا مشكورا، وذنوبهم ذنوبا مغفورا، وأعمالهم أعمالا صالحا مقبولا، وتجارة لن تبور. يا نور النور يا عالم ما في الصدور، أخرجنا يا الله يا الله يا الله من الظلمات إلى النور. ربنا عليك توكلنا وإليك أنبنا وإليك المصير. ربنا لا تجعلنا فتنة للذين كفروا، واغفر لنا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار، وادخلنا الجنة والأبرار يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين. وصلى الله على سيدنا ونبينا مولانا محمد نبي الأمي وعلى آله وأصحابه وبارك وسلم، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. الفاتحة. تفضل إمام.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، يا عظيم السلطان، يا قديم الإحسان، يا دائم النعم، يا كثير الجود، يا واسع العطاء، يا حفي اللطف، يا جميع الصن، يا حليم، يا صلي على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في الأولين، اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في الآخرين، اللهم صل على سيدنا كل وقت وحين، اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد حتى ترث الأرض ومن عليها، وأنت خير الوارثين. يا مولانا يا رب العالمين، اللهم إنا نسألك جهد البلاء وترك الشقاء وصول القضاء وشماتة العذاب برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا نعوذ من العجز والكسل وجمن والبخل وغلبة الدين وقهر الرجال. يا مولانا يا رب العالمين، اللهم ارزقنا من أكل أوفرها، ومن الألحان أصفاها، ومن الأخلاق أطيبها، أرزاق أجزلها، ومن الدنيا خيرها، والآخرة نعيمها يا رب العالمين. اللهم أجرنا من النار، اللهم أجرنا من النار، اللهم أجرنا من النار يا مجير يا مجير. اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وذنوب والدينا وشيخ المسلمين أجمعين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اغفر له وارحمه في الجنة، اللهم اغفر لها وارحمه في الجنة، اللهم اغفر لهم وارحمه درجاتهم الجنة برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. رب الناس أذلم البأس شوى تشافي، لا شفاء فضل السقم. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم أعز المجاهدين في كل مكان، في فلسطين، في بلاد الشام، في اليمن، في كشمير، في هند، في الصين، يا رب العالمين. يا مولانا يا رب العالمين، اللهم اغفر للحجاج ولمن استغفر الحجاج. اللهم اجعلهم حجهم حجا مبرورا، وسعيهم سعيا مشكورا، وذنوبهم مغفورا، وأعمالهم أعمالا صالحا مقبولا، وتجارتهم تجارة لن تبور. يا نور النور يا عالم ما في الصدور، أخرجنا يا الله يا الله من الظلمات إلى النور برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكن من الخاسرين. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا واغفر لنا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. ربنا يسر ولا تؤسر، ربنا تمن بالخير وأنت الكريم يسر. ربنا آمنا بما أنزلت واتبعنا الرسول فاكتبنا مع الشاهدين. يا مولانا يا رب العالمين، رزم البركة نهائي وسورة الفاتحة. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. وفي لنا ولوالدنا والدحير الراحمين. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وأصحابه وسلم. اللهم افتح لنا بالخير وتم لنا بالخير واجعل واجهنا بالخير إنك الخير والعافية إنك على كل شيء قدير. ألا إن أولياء الله لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون الذين آمنوا وكانوا يتقون فضلك دعواهم فيها سبحانك اللهم وتحية فيها سلام وآخر دعواهم الحمد لله رب العالمين. اللهم صل على محمد يا رب صل عليه وسلم. اللهم صل على محمد يا رب صل عليه وسلم. اللهم صل على محمد يا رب صل عليه وسلم. الله اللهم صل على محمد يا رب صل عليه وسلم. اللهم صل على محمد يا رب صل عليه وسلم. صلوات على النبي. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us. Shukran to everybody that has participated. Alhamdulillah, small step in the program. Alhamdulillah, to keep the momentum alive. Alhamdulillah. We can go and have a cup of tea, inshallah, ta'ala, maybe a Wilson block, maybe a fruitcake, and also that round hubcap rooties, inshallah. Enjoy. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us to be together again, inshallah, and beyond this, to be together the akhirah and Jannah, inshallah, ta'ala. Shukran to everybody that was involved behind the scenes. Akhiru da'wana, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
Shukran. Assalamu alaikum, ya Imam.